So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. So guys, most of you were asking for the revision of Atmanirbhar Bharat package. So in today's session, we are going to revise Atmanirbhar package part 1 and the part 2 and 3 I'll bring to you in the next session, right? So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes, and you can also ask any doubts here, right? And we have launched the RBI Grade B 2020-22 course, and you can avail 30% discount on this course by using this code RBI30, all right? So let's begin with the session, guys, and let's talk about the Atmanirbhar Bharat package part 1. So we all know the Atmanirbhar package part 1 was launched in the May 2020. It was announced by the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the month of May 2020, and the total corpus of this package was how much? 20 lakh crores. Okay, 20 lakh crore ka package tha. It was announced by Prime Minister in the month of May 2020, and it was said that it is India's 10% of the GDP. India ki GDP ka 10% government ne package mein announce kiya tha, that is worth rupees 20 lakh crores, all right? And now let's first of all talk about the new definition of MSMEs. जो MSMEs की definition थी उसको change किया गया था, उसमें कुछ changes लाए गए थे. And now the MSMEs are classified into one category only, that is manufacturing and services. Earlier there were two categories. Number one is manufacturing, number two is services. Now उन दोनों को merge करके एक category बना दी थी, that is manufacturing and services. All right. And for the micro enterprises, what is the threshold limit? Investment less than 1 crore. Turnover should be less than 5 crores. For the small enterprises, investment should be less than 10 crores, while the turnover should be less than 50 crores. While for the medium enterprises, the investment should be less than 50 crores and turnover should be less than 250 crores. So you should remember this new criteria, new classification of MSMEs. This can be asked in your exam, all right? And talking about equity infusion, so there was some equity infusion in MSMEs worth rupees 50,000 crore. 50,000 crore ka equity infusion kiya gaya tha through a mother of funds. Okay, a fund of funds with corpus rupees 10,000 crores was created, and through this fund of funds, rupees 50,000 crore was targeted to be leveraged through this fund of funds. Okay, isme kya tha? Basically ek mother fund tha. There was a mother fund and few daughter funds. So let us say this mother fund is worth rupees 10,000 crore. Ye jo mother fund tha, ye kitne ka tha? 10,000 crore ka. And there are few daughter funds. Let us say there are 5 daughter funds of 2,000 crore each. To ye jo daughter funds the, ye kya karenge? Ye aage shares mein ya bonds mein invest karenge, and they will earn money. And it was targeted that it will generate 50,000 crore as the equity infusion for the MSMEs. All right. And the next step for MSMEs was for the stressed MSMEs, 20,000 crore subordinated debt was provided. 20,000 crore rupees subordinated debt ke liye diye the for those MSMEs which are under stress or which have a large NPA, which are not performing well. So 20,000 crore subordinated debt for 2 lakh MSMEs was announced, which are under NPA or are stressed, and government has provided guarantee for this. And kitni guarantee di thi government ne? Government provided 4,000 crore ka guarantee through Credit Guarantee Trust for Micro and Small Enterprises, which is maintained by SIDBI. Remember this, it is maintained by SIDBI, and through this trust, through this Credit Guarantee Trust, government provided 4,000 crore guarantee for this subordinated debt of rupees 20,000 crore. And remember, ye jo subordinated debt tha, that was given to those, that was given to the investors, jinke paas stressed MSMEs hai, equal to 15% of their existing stake in the unit, subjected to a maximum of how much? Rupees 75 lakh. Kitna diya tha? 15% unka jo bhi total stake hai, uska 15% subjected to a maximum of rupees 75 lakhs. Alright. For businesses, including MSMEs, rupees 3 lakh crores collateral free automatic loans government ne diye the. Aur iske liye condition thi that the additional working capital finance of 20% of the outstanding credit will be provided as on 29th February 2020 in the form of a term loan. So basically a term loan will be provided. Aur wo term loan kitna hoga? 20% of the outstanding credit. 20% of the outstanding credit jo bhi hoga as on 29th February 2020, utna loan provide karaya jayega, and this loan will be collateral and automatic. Okay, collateral free loan hoga aur bilkul automatic loan hoga. Iske liye koi collateral nahi dena padega. And this will be available to units with up to 25 crore outstanding. Jo minimum, jo maximum outstanding hai, that should be how much? Rupees 25 crore. Maximum outstanding kitna hona chahiye? 25 crore. और जो टर्नओवर है दैट शुड बी अप टू रुपीज 100 करोड़. उन्हीं एमएसएमईज को ये वाला लोन अवेल कराया गया था बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड द टेन्योर ऑफ द लोन वाज 4 ईयर विद मॉरेटोरियम ऑफ 12 मंथ्स ऑन प्रिंसिपल रीपेमेंट एंड द स्कीम वाज अवेलेबल अप टू 31st October 2020. रिमेंबर दिस डेट ऑल्सो. एंड द यूनिट्स विल नॉट हैव टू प्रोवाइड एनी गारंटी एंड कोलेटरल ऑफ देयर ओन एज द नेम मेंशन्ड एंड द अमाउंट विल बी 100% गारंटीड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने इसका पूरा 100% गारंटी दिया था कि अगर कोई डिफॉल्ट करता है तो देन गवर्नमेंट विल पे बैक टू द बैंक्स, राइट. एंड नो ग्लोबल टेंडर्स फॉर गवर्नमेंट टेंडर्स ऑफ अप टू रुपीज 200 करोड़. सो अंडर द जनरल फाइनेंशियल रूल्स, जनरल फाइनेंशियल रूल्स को अमेंड किया गया. दीज रूल्स वर अमेंडेड एंड इट वॉज सेड दैट नाउ द ग्लोबल टेंडर इंक्वायरीज इन प्रोक्योरमेंट ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज ऑफ वैल्यू लेस देन 200 करोड़ विल नॉट बी अलाउड. बेसिकली 200 करोड़ से कम का जो भी ग्लोबल 200 करोड़ की जो भी गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज का तक का वैल्यू होगा उसके लिए ग्लोबल टेंडर अलाउ नहीं किया जाएगा. ओके. ईपीएफ सपोर्ट फॉर बिजनेस एंड वर्कर्स, उसके लिए कितना दिया था गवर्नमेंट ने? ₹2,500 करोड़ एंड इट वॉज अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण पैकेज. रिमेंबर दिस, अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण पैकेज गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइडेड 12% ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड 12% ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन टू द ईपीएफ अकाउंट ऑफ द एलिजिबल एस्टैब्लिशमेंट. ओके, जो भी एलिजिबल एस्टैब्लिशमेंट थे 12% of the employees contribution and 12% of the employee contribution was provided by the central government into the eligible EPF accounts. And ye kab tak ke liye provide kiya gaya tha? August 2020 tak ke liye. Remember this. And remember there was a condition also that this scheme was for those wage earners who have salary less than 15,000 per month and who are working in those businesses which have less than 100 workers. All right. And there is one more EPF contribution related thing which is for employers and employees. और उनमें क्या किया था? Basically जो उनका contribution था उसको reduce कर दिया था. Statutory PF contribution. Remember this word. Statutory PF contribution of both employer and employee reduced to 10%. 10% कर दिया था from the existing 12%. जो कि उस time कितना था? 12%. 12% से कम करके 10% कर दिया for 3 months. And remember, जो सेंट्रल पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइजेस के एम्प्लॉइज थे या स्टेट पीएसयूज के थे या जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट में थे वो कंटिन्यू रखेंगे अपना कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन. उनके लिए कोई रिबेट नहीं दी गई थी. देर वॉज नो रिबेट टू द एम्प्लॉइज वर्किंग इन द सेंट्रल पब्लिक सेक्टर अंडरटेकिंग्स और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट पीएसयूज, राइट. एंड दिस विल प्रोवाइड लिक्विडिटी ऑफ अबाउट 2 to 50 crore पर मंथ अकॉर्डिंग टू द एस्टिमेट्स दैट वॉज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. NBFCs, housing finance companies and microfinance institutions ke liye government provided 75,000 crore. Government provided how much? 75,000 crore for NBFCs, microfinance institutions and housing finance companies or in the form of two schemes. Ye jo 75,000 crore the, ye do schemes ke form mein diya tha. Number one is the special liquidity scheme. Special liquidity scheme mein kya tha? Under this scheme, investments will be made in both primary and secondary market transaction in the investment grade debt papers issued by NBFCs, housing finance companies or the microfinance institution. And this scheme was worth rupees how much? 30,000 crore. Iske liye kitna diya tha? 30,000 crore, while the rest 45,000 crore was for the another scheme. And it will supplement RBI or the government measures to augment liquidity. It will of course increase the liquidity in the market because jab koi security khareedenge to usse liquidity market mein generate hogi. And partial credit guarantee scheme 2.0 worth rupees 45,000 crore. And under this, basically, it is a credit guarantee scheme. Jo bhi credit housing finance companies or microfinance institutions or NBFCs ko diya jayega, uske liye guarantee di thi government ne for the first 20% loss. First 20% of loss will be borne by the guarantor and in this case, the guarantor was the central government. Basically, ye jo loans denge NBFCs, housing finance companies ya microfinance institution aur agar unme koi loss ho jata hai unko, so the first 20% of the loss will be borne by the central government who is a guarantor in this scheme. And talking about the DISCOMs, for the distribution companies, 90,000 crore rupees was provided. 90,000 crore rupees was provided. And this 90,000 crore, what was the purpose of this? So this 90,000 crore they can use to pay their dues to the transmission and generation companies. Jo bhi unke ऊपर ड्यूज थे ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन एंड जनरेशन कंपनीज, उन ड्यूज को पे आउट करने के लिए दिस 90,000 करोड़ वाज प्रोवाइडेड. एंड एट दैट टाइम इट वाज एस्टिमेटेड दैट देयर इज अ ड्यू ऑफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 94,000 करोड़. सो उनको कितना ड्यू पे करना था? 94,000 करोड़ का. सो उसके लिए 90,000 करोड़ रुपीज वॉज प्रोवाइडेड टू द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज सो दैट दे कैन क्लियर आउट देयर ड्यूज. कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स, जितनी भी सेंट्रल एजेंसीज लाइक रेलवे, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड हाईवे, CPWDs, they were given mandated that they have to extend the deadline of the project for up to 6 months. जितने भी deadline थे projects की उनको 6 महीने तक के लिए आपको बढ़ा देना है. This was given, this mandate was given to all the central agencies like railways, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, CPWD. There was a deduction in TDS and TCC, tax deducted at source rates for all the non-salaried employees. जितने भी non-salaried employees की payment थी to residents and tax collected at source. That was reduced by 25%. कितना हो गया था? उसको reduce कर दिया था by 25%. Basically, the rates of TDS and TCC was reduced by 25%. And this reduction shall be applicable for the remaining part of the specified rates for the remaining period for the financial year 2021. पूरे financial year के लिए it was applicable. And remember, government estimated that it will provide a liquidity in the economy worth rupees 50,000 crore. 50,000 crore की liquidity ये देगा. It was estimated by the government. Free food grain supply to migrants was provided under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. We all know. And there was a scheme for affordable rental housing complexes for migrant workers and urban poor that was to be launched. And it has been launched now. Under this, affordable rental housing complexes will be provided to the, socially weak sections of the society, jo economically or socially weak sections hai hamari society ko, they will be provided the affordable rental housing complexes. And ye affordable rental housing complexes basically ye do parts mein divide kiye gaye the by the government. One that will be made jo ki banaye jayenge by providing fund from the government of India, aur dusra ye hoga ki jo existing government ke offices hain ya koi aisi building hai jiska use nahi ho raha hai, they will be converted into the affordable rental housing complexes, and that facility will be provided to the socially and economically weak sections of the society. All right. And moving ahead to the next provision, 2% interest subvention for 12 months for Shishu Mudra loan. 1500 crore rupees government ne iske liye diye the. Jo bhi Shishu Mudra loan wale the, Mudra mein teen hote hain, hame pata hai, Shishu, Kishore aur Tarun. To jo Shishu loan beneficiary the, unko 2% ka interest subvention provide karaya gaya tha. 2% interest subvention was given to the Shishu Loni beneficiaries, and this will provide relief of about 1500 crores to the Shishu Mudra Lonis. All right. Now credit facility for street vendors. So we all know, iske liye government ne kitna diya tha? 5000 crore. Government has provided rupees 5000 crore for this credit facility to the street vendors. And later government launched PM Swanidhi scheme, and we all know under the scheme 10,000 rupees per annum, 10,000 rupees as a loan is provided to the street vendors for 1 year. Extension of credit link subsidy scheme under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. It was extended up to March 2021, which means 31st March 2021 tak isko extend kar diya gaya tha. But the earlier deadline was how much? Was what? 31st March 2020. The scheme was up to 31st March 2020, but during the Atmanirbhar package, it was extended up to March 2021. 2021 tak isko extend kar diya tha, and for that rupees 70,000 crore was provided by the government. And credit link subsidy scheme mein kya hota hai? That government provides subsidy on buying a house to the EWS low income group and middle income group families, and for that 70,000 crore rupees, remember the amount also, was provided by the government of India. For the camper funds for afforestation and plantation work, rupees 6,000 crore was provided. 6000 rupees crore diye the kiske liye? Camper funds ke liye. And remember, camper stands for compensatory afforestation management and planning authority. Do you remember the full form of CAMPA also? And for this fund, rupees 6,000 crore was provided by the government, and it was estimated that it will create job opportunities in urban, semi-urban and rural areas, and for the tribal people also. Moving ahead to the another provision, which is additional emergency working capital for farmers through NABARD. So 30,000 crore was given to NABARD so that they can provide additional credit to the farmers for meeting their crop loan requirements of rural cooperative banks and regional rural banks. Jo bhi crop loan requirements hain regional cooperative banks ke aur regional rural banks ke, wo pura kiye ja sake. Iske liye 30,000 crore additional liquidity was provided to NABARD. And remember, it was over and above the rupees 90,000 crore that was provided by NABARD to this sector in the normal course. Normal course mein kitna dete hain? 90,000 crore rupees. Uske upar ye 30,000 crore rupees government ne diye the under this package. A special drive for farmers under Kisan Credit Card Scheme worth rupees 2 lakh crores. So it was to provide concessional credit to the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi PM Kisan beneficiaries through the Kisan Credit Cards. And isme agriculture ke alawa jo allied sectors hain unke beneficiaries ko bhi benefit diya gaya tha by the government. So fishermen and animal husbandry farmers were also included in this drive. All right. And moving ahead to another provision, which was the agri infrastructure fund. So you should know that 1 lakh crore ka agricultural infrastructure fund was created. That is to create agricultural infrastructure at farm gate and at aggregation points. फार्म गेट पे और एग्रीगेशन पॉइंट्स पे 1 लाख इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप करने के लिए 1 लाख करोड़ रुपए का एग्रीकल्चरल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फंड वॉज क्रिएटेड अंडर आत्मनिर्भर पैकेज पार्ट वन. फॉर द माइक्रो फूड इंटरप्राइजेस इट वॉज अनाउंस दैट दे विल लॉन्च अ स्कीम वर्थ ₹10,000 करोड़. 10,000 करोड़ की एक स्कीम लॉन्च करेंगे सो दैट द माइक्रो फूड एंटरप्राइजेस को सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराई जा सके फाइनेंशियल एंड टेक्निकल. एंड आफ्टर एंड लेटर अ स्कीम वॉज ऑल्सो लॉन्च विच इज नोन एज प्रधान Prime Minister's formalization of micro food processing enterprises scheme. That scheme is worth ₹10,000 crore. The total corpus, the total outlay of the scheme is ₹10,000 crore, and this is to provide financial and technical support to the micro food enterprises of our country. Next, Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. ये हमने detail में discuss किया था. So total ₹20,000 crore का ये scheme था, and this was launched for integrated, sustainable, and inclusive development of marine and the inland fisheries sector of our country. Basically, जो हमारा fishery sector है उसको develop करने के लिए this scheme was launched, प्रधानमंत्री मत्स्य संपदा योजना. And remember, ₹20,000 crore was provided for implementation of this scheme. And moving ahead to another provision, that is the National Animal Disease Control Program. So to control the animal diseases and specifically for the foot and mouth disease and brucellosis, this announcement was made by the government, and for this ₹13,343 crore was provided, and this was to ensure 100% vaccination of cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat and pig population so that they can be saved off these foot and mouth diseases and brucellosis. All right. Animal husbandry infrastructure development fund worth ₹1,500 crore was set up with an aim to support private investment in dairy processing, value addition and cattle feed infrastructure. So this is very important. Do remember this. Animal Husbandry Infrastructure Development Fund worth ₹1,500 crore was created. And moving ahead to another part, that is the promotion of herbal cultivation with a total outlay of how much? ₹4,000 crore. 4,000 crore rupay ke total outlay ke saath herbal cultivation was announced to be promoted, and for this the National Medicinal Plants Board has supported 2.25 lakh hectare area under the cultivation of medicinal plants, and 10 lakh hectares will be covered under the herbal cultivation project, and for that ₹4,000 crore was provided under this package. For beekeeping initiatives, ₹500 crore was provided for implementing a scheme for infrastructure development related to the integrated beekeeping development. Beekeeping ke development ke liye, integrated beekeeping ke development ke liye ₹500 crore was provided so that the infrastructure related to the integrated beekeeping can be developed. All right, so remember this, ₹500 crore was provided for this, and it will lead to increase in income for 2 lakh beekeepers and quality honey to the consumers. From top to total, so earlier there was a scheme that was launched by the government of India, which was for the for increasing the production of 3 crops, tomato, onion and potato, and later it was enhanced to top to total. And total mein kya the, sare fruits and vegetable, all fruits and vegetables were included later, all fruits and vegetable, and for this ₹500 crore was provided by the government under the Atmanirbhar package. Okay, so subsidy provision bhi thi isme. The scheme would provide 50% subsidy on transportation for surplus to deficient markets, 50% subsidy on storage including cold storages. And if you remember, under the PM Kisan Rail also, under the Kisan Rail also, 50% subsidy was provided under the top to total scheme by the government of India through the Ministry of Food Processing Industry. Okay. And talking about the coal sector, so commercial mining ko competitive banane ke liye, transparent banane ke liye, aur private sector ke participation ko badhane ke liye, government ne kuch steps lene ki baat ki thi. Like for example, a revenue sharing mechanism will be promoted. Earlier it was according to the rupee per ton. Entry norms were liberalized and nearly 50 blocks were offered immediately. Exploration cum production regime for partially explored blocks, and other than this, incentivized rebate. Rebates ko bhi incentivized kiya gaya tha. So these are some steps which was taken by the government to promote competition, transparency and private sector involvement in the commercial mining sector. So this guys can use in your essays part. And talking about mining plan simplification, so ease of doing business measures such as mining plan simplification was considered and it was expected to increase annual production by 40%. जो माइनिंग का प्लान है उसको सिंप्लीफाई कर दिया जाएगा सो दैट द ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस कैन बी प्रमोटेड एंड इट वाज एक्सपेक्टेड इट वाज एस्टिमेटेड दैट इट वुड लीड टू द इंक्रीज इन एनुअल प्रोडक्शन बाय 40% 40% इन एनुअल प्रोडक्शन इससे इंक्रीज होने के संभावना है एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ₹50,000 crore विल बी डन फॉर इवैक्यूएशन ऑफ एनहांस कोल इंडिया लिमिटेड प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटी जो कोल इंडिया लिमिटेड है उसकी प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटी को बढ़ाने के लिए इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप किया जाएगा एंड फॉर दैट ₹50,000 crore वॉज प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस पैकेज आत्मनिर्भर वन टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिफेंस सेक्टर सो फॉर रिड्यूसिंग इम्पोर्ट सम स्टेप्स वर अनाउंस टू बी टेकन फॉर एग्जाम्पल नोटिफाइंग अ लिस्ट ऑफ वेपन्स ऑफ द प्लेटफॉर्म सो दैट देर विल बी अ प्रॉपर बैन ऑन दोज ऑन इम्पोर्ट ऑफ दीज वेपन्स स्पेयर्स पार्ट ऑफ दीज वेपन्स हैव टू बी मैन्युफैक्चर्ड लोकली separate budget provisioning for domestic capital procurement so these are the some steps that was announced to be taken so that jo hamari import ki dependency hai usko kam kiya ja sake moving ahead to the policy reform so fdi limit in the defense manufacturing was announced to be reduced from 49% to 74% and has now been reduced it has now been increased to 74% kitna ho gaya ab ye 74% ho gaya hai it was announced in the atmanirbhar package remember this डिफेंस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में एफडीआई लिमिट कितना है 74% एंड इन द अदर सेक्टर्स ऑफ डिफेंस देयर इज अ लिमिट ऑफ 100% इन द 100% एफडीआई एंड आउट ऑफ दिस 100% 74% इज थ्रू द ऑटोमेटिक रूट व्हाइल अबव 70% इज थ्रू द गवर्नमेंट रूट राइट एंड देयर इज अ प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट यूनिट दैट वॉज सेटअप टू यू नो टू कीप अ चेक ऑन द डिफेंस ऑन द टाइम बाउंड डिफेंस प्रोक्योरमेंट प्रोसेस एंड फास्टर डिसीजन मेकिंग which will support the contract management and the long time jo bahut time se pending tha corporatization of the ordnance factory board it was also approved during the atmanirbhar package right and talking about the civil aviation sector so world class airports will be built through the public private partnership mode in the public private partnership mode world class airports banaye jayenge and in the first second and third round bidding 666 airports each were allowed under the public private partnership mode that is to be built under this project of building world class airports all right and India will be made a global hub for aircraft maintenance repair and overhaul and for this tax regime for MRO ecosystem was rationalized which led to the cost cutting and also remember the aircraft component repairs and airframe maintenance to be that was announced to be increased from ₹800 crores to ₹2000 crores in the upcoming 3 years जो एयरक्राफ्ट कंपोनेंट रिपेयर्स और एयर फ्रेम का मेंटेनेंस की जो मार्केट है अभी 800 करोड़ रुपए की है उसको इंक्रीज करके कितना कर दिया जाएगा 2000 करोड़ इन द अपकमिंग 3 इयर्स ओके एंड मूविंग अहेड टू द सोशल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट सो इन्वेस्टमेंट विल बी डन थ्रू द वायबिलिटी गैप फंडिंग एज अनाउंस बाय द गवर्नमेंट वर्थ ₹8100 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाएगा इन द सोशल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट एज इट वॉज अनाउंस बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड रिमेंबर At that time, most of the projects were supported by the center government or the state government or the statutory bodies with 20% as the viability gap funding. But it was announced that the government will increase this 20% to how much? 30%. 20% को कितना कर देंगे? 30% कर देंगे. जो 20% viability gap funding में government fund दे रही थी, उसको बढ़ा के कितना कर दिया जाएगा? 30%. And MNREGA में we all know ₹40,000 crore का additional fund was provided by the government. टेक्नोलॉजी ड्रिवन एजुकेशन के लिए पीएम ई विद्या प्रोग्राम वॉज लॉन्च बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड अंडर दिस दीज आर सम इनिशिएटिव दैट वॉज टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट लाइक अंडर दीक्षा फॉर स्कूल एजुकेशन इन स्टेट्स और यूटीज ई कंटेंट वॉज प्रोवाइडेड टू ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज टू ऑल द चिल्ड्रन जो कि अलग अलग स्टेट्स और यूटीज में पढ़ रहे हैं वन टीवी चैनल पर क्लास वॉज देयर फॉर क्लास फ्रॉम क्लास फर्स्ट टू क्लास ट्वेल्थ एक्सटेंसिव यूज ऑफ रेडियो कम्युनिटी रेडियो एंड पॉडकास्ट स्पेशल ई कंटेंट फॉर विजुअली एंड हियरिंग इम्पेयर्ड एंड एक्सेट्रा बेसिकली गवर्नमेंट जो भी डिजिटल एजुकेशन को डिजिटलाइज करने के लिए जो भी कर सकती थी गवर्नमेंट ने स्टेप लिए एंड रिमेंबर द अम्ब्रेला स्कीम वॉज नेम्ड एज पीएम ई विद्या ओके पीएम ई विद्या के अंदर ये सारे स्टेप्स लिए गए थे बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टू डिजिटलाइज द एजुकेशन एंड देर वॉज एन इनिशिएटिव मनोदर्पण दैट वॉज लॉन्च फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग साइको सोशल सपोर्ट टू द स्टूडेंट्स क्योंकि कोविड के टाइम में साइको सोशल सपोर्ट की जरूरत थी स्टूडेंट्स को सो फॉर दैट दिस मनोदर्पण इनिशिएटिव वाज लॉन्च बाय द गवर्नमेंट न्यू नेशनल करिकुलम एंड पेडागोजिकल फ्रेमवर्क फॉर स्कूल अर्ली चाइल्डहुड एंड टीचर्स विल बी लॉन्च्ड And also, National Foundation Literacy and Numeracy Mission was also launched for the students. All right. Moving ahead to the provisions related to IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. So, minimum threshold limit to initiate the solvency proceeding was increased to 1 crore. पहले कितना था? 1 लाख रुपए. उसको बढ़ा के कितना कर दिया गया? 1 करोड़ रुपए. Special Insolvency Resolution Framework for MSMEs under the Section 240A of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code was notified. MSMEs के लिए एक स्पेशल सेक्शन था, उसको नोटिफाई किया गया. सस्पेंशन ऑफ फ्रेश इनिशिएशन ऑफ इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोसीडिंग्स अप टू वन ईयर. एक साल के लिए जितनी भी फ्रेश इनिशिएशन थी ऑफ द इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोसीडिंग उसको सस्पेंड कर दिया गया. एंड रिमेंबर ऑल द कोविड-19 रिलेटेड डेट्स वर एक्सक्लूडेड फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिफॉल्ट. ओके, जितने भी कोविड-19 रिलेटेड डेट्स थे उनको एक्सक्लूड कर दिया गया फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिफॉल्ट अंडर आईबीसी. And moving ahead to the measures related to Companies Act. So, violations which involve minor technical and procedural defaults, including shortcoming in CSR reporting, etc., were kept out of the definition of decriminalization. Okay, unko decriminalization ki definition se bahar kar diya, and these amendments will lessen the cases in criminal courts and the National Company Law Tribunals. Now, what was the support that was provided to the states? So, center has decided to increase borrowing limits of states from 3% to 5% for this financial year. 3% se 5% tak wo enhanced borrowing le sakte the. And this will give this, it was estimated that this will give states extra resources of rupees 4.28 lakh crores. 4.828 lakh crore ka extra resource states ko milega, it was estimated. And remember, part of the borrowing will be linked to the specific reforms, and we all know there were four reforms. I don't have to repeat this. Char reforms ke bare mein hum pehle bhi baat kar chuke hain. One is One Nation Card, power sector reforms, and there are two more that you have to tell me in the comments. Do aapko aur batane hain, hum char kai baar pad chuke hain, to do ye hain, do aapko comment mein likh ke batane. And the states can borrow more in the following pattern. Like first, unconditional increase of 0.50%, जो वो 3 से 5% का है, उसमें कुछ conditions हैं, ऐसे कोई भी जाके नहीं मिलेगा. First, unconditional increase of 0.50%. Next, 1% in 4 tranches of 0.25% with each tranche linked to the specified reforms. And further, 0.50% if milestones are achieved in at least 3 out of the 4 reforms areas. Okay. And which are the two states जिन्होंने 4 में से 3 reforms करके दिखाए थे? Write down in the comments. All right, guys, so that was about the Atmanirbhar package part 1. So it was a quick revision of all the provisions of Atmanirbhar Bharat. I hope all the provisions are clear. In the next session, I will bring to you the second and third part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. Till then, keep watching anujindal.in. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.